Hello and welcome back to Robinsunne Art Studio. My name is Robinsunne. Please like, comment, subscribe, and share this video. I'm so sorry, I hit the camera. So I'm doing this really fun thing and I just thought it would be terrific to share it with you. I think these are going to turn into little postage stamps, but first I want to tell you that I have been watching Camellia Crafts Design, her website, and her YouTube channel, and she's wonderful, and she's making all these 2 inch by 3 inch little booklets. I'll show you. She is using Tim Holtz papers, but they're just little notebooks, you know, that have a little bit of paper inside of them. Do these all have the same paper? Yes, they do. And she's using Tim Holtz paper, and so it's very interesting. I don't have any Tim Holtz paper, not because I don't like it, but just because it's this thing I have about wanting to express myself, so I keep wanting to make my own cool papers. So, I think a while ago in December, you might remember if you've been following my channel at all, that I made some rubber stamps, like these. Oh, I also made that. I don't have that. But lots of different rubber stamps. And at one point, I made prints of a whole bunch. So I had 30 brand new rubber stamps, 31. Because Julie Fafan Balzer's challenge for December, it's called hashtag Carve December, and you make a new rubber stamp for each day of the month. And I love doing, well, this is the first time I've ever done it. So I loved doing that because it gave me 31 new stamps, which was really fun. And I have been sort of a postcard crazy person for a couple of years, and what I did was I took the rubber stamps that I made. Well, maybe this way is the better way to show you. Heart's right side up and the bird is right side up. This is upside down, but branches grow like that. So anyway, I enlarged them so that on a 4x6 postcard they would fit properly. And that was very fun. But I was watching, I can't remember her name, on Camellia Crafts Design. And she had all these, Tim Holtz makes all these tickets and things. You can find his work, I think, on Amazon most easily. So he makes these, you know, like a ticket that's that big. And then sometimes he makes these little packages of minis. And, you know, they're like this big. They're really tiny, which is really fun. So she was making Camellia was making these little booklets and then was able to put on these little tiny stickers of Tim Holtz. And I thought, I had made postcards out of the rubber stamps. What if I shrunk them, sort of like Tim Holtz did with his designs, and turned them into little teeny tiny stamps? So off I went to my printer today, and I took all of these images down to that's sort of a combo image. But I pulled them down to 25%. And maybe you can see there are these little copy shadow lines in some of them. So that's kind of a drag. So I've been trying to really carefully cut these so that I was getting rid of all the little black lines. And then I am trying to line them up on black paper to make just sort of a well-defined little image. And then what I will do, and my scissors, here they are, I can take some, like I'll put this image, I'll glue it on a piece of white cardstock, and then I can take my stamp scissors make little postcards, I mean postage stamps out of them. Isn't that beautiful? This is a really cool image. I like that. It has special meaning to somebody in my life, and therefore, I love it. This is my initial, I realize, but it would make a really cool... Did you know you could go to Zazzle.com? I don't get paid by them. I mean, unless you buy one of my images. And you can have them make stamps out of your images. So I might do that too. I love this bird. Yeah, so you can do that with all of these. And of course you can print in color. That's completely fine. I just kind of decided that would be fine to do in black and white. And then if I wanted, I could color this in colors. Or you could ink the edges. You can do a lot of things to put color on this. And then, you could do a wet on wet watercolor. You wet the paper, the watercolor paper, and then you kind of mush paint, watercolor paint on it, and it bleeds into all the places the first water went down, so it's wet on wet. And you get these lovely soft colors. So you could print out a piece of dried watercolored paper and then print these onto that. So you could do that too to make color. But anyway, I was just having fun doing this and I thought you might enjoy and you might get some ideas. So I want to work on this one. So let's see. Can you see the little copier line that's right across the top? So I want to... I think this line looks fairly straight. So I'm going to line the edge of this paper up with one of the lines here. Make sure I push this out far enough to get rid of that little black line. And it worked. And then I can just keep lining it up against these edges. There we go. I'll get my black paper. And I've got a piece of glue paper. And I'm using glue stick with this just because it's the driest glue I've got, and so it won't, if you use wet white glue, it can warp the paper, and I'm trying to be perfect today as an artist. Because, I'm human and I'm not really perfect. Okay. So that's crooked. That's a bummer. Okay. Just do it. Just do it. It's really wide. It's impossible to talk. See? Isn't that sweet? So there's this thing that I've been thinking about talking about here on my channel that, tell me if this happens to you too. I was talking to a friend and I was talking too much. I'd been drinking coffee and that's all on me. And I was talking about when I was in college out near San Francisco. I didn't go to Berkeley, but there was a movie theater in Berkeley that had, I don't know, like, oh, look what I just did. Oh, how ridiculous. That had all this string of movies that were made by Buster Keaton, Charlie Chaplin, and Harold Lloyd. I think there might have been some other people mixed in, but those three guys got the sort of lead billing on the series. And while I was watching those movies, I realized it's so intriguing. At the beginning of movie making, these three men, but especially Buster Keaton, because he really worked for himself for a long time, and before he became a part of a corporation. Charlie Chaplin was more famous, I think, but he made himself into a corporation, and a lot of the decision making of the films got handed around to the people in his corporation. But Buster Keaton was kind of rare in that he didn't do that. He worked for himself, he was the writer. He was a major actor, whoever the lead guy character was. He also ended up doing a lot of the directing on the movie, and he was the main producer because he was the guy who said, "This is my vision, this is what I want the story to be, this is how it's going to work. These are the people I want working with me." So the other, the villain and the love interest and all the other people in his stories. And so what happened was, and this was back a couple decades, so modern movies, the big movie houses were a thing. And when you look at a movie that's made today, like several people are the writers, and there's a director who has an awful lot to say about the end of the movie, what the movie shapes out to be, but so does the one or many producers, and they all get hired by casting companies that specialize in casting movies. So they don't even work for the studio necessarily. They work independently. And then there are the people on the cutting, in the cutting room, the editing. And so sometimes a movie needs to be longer or shorter. And so scenes will be, more detail will be in a scene or less detail because they need to cut the time. So stuff won't even show up. Stuff that's been filmed and written in won't show up in the end of the movie because the corporations of the movie houses now need to have movies be a specific amount of minutes. None of those restraints were on Buster Keaton, and he decided everything. So the story he told was just his story, which is an amazing thing to think about. Like, you could pick a topic or pick a storyline, or you could decide, I mean, if you did it Buster Keaton's way, he decided everything. He decided how the movie would start and how it would end. Lots of times there are stories where he found certain props or something, and he thought, oh, this would be fun to play with. And so he'd build that into a movie that, anyway, it was all his vision. It was all his story. And that's neither good nor bad necessarily, except that it's very different from the movies the Big House movies that I was seeing in college. So I just thought, oh, that's a thing. That's a consideration. You can have lots of people helping you, but then the story becomes infused with the notions and the desires of all the other people working on the film. Or you can do it alone, which may or may not be harder, but it makes the story all one's own. Anyway, what this has to do with art is that when I make a little folio or a little notebook or a little anything, and I use all my designs, it just feels like me in a way that neither good nor bad, but it's just, it's delicious. I love working in that way. So, trying to not get glue. So this is why, long story, but this is why I wander around not buying Tim Holtz stuff, not because Tim's stuff isn't gorgeous, because it totally is. I like it very much. But because Tim Holtz is telling a different story than I am. And it's an artistic exercise for me to tell my own story. I just like it. That's fun. And so I get ideas from people like Tim Holtz, who make images that are large, and then they shrink them into little teeny tiny half inch by half inch whatchamacallits. And then I use some of the same decorating techniques that channels like Camilla Craft Design. Is that what she's called? No, I've forgotten. I really like her so much. She's hilarious. Camellia Crafts Designs. Yeah. So it's just fun to watch. So, yeah, she's fun to watch. And she's the story in her making of art things. One more. That one. There. Can you see them all? I hope you've been able to see this. I hope I've stayed in camera focus. I've got my camera in a little bit new place. So today, my blessing wish for you is may you know what your own story is and delight in that. May you have fun telling your own story. And I'll see you next time. Bye.